Have you ever wondered what the best game engine is? I mean, I hope so, because that's what the video is about. I already wrote the script and everything. And if that is the case, then you're in luck, because today I'm gonna talk about all the main game engines and which one is the best for you. Because as always, the answer is, it depends. When picking a game engine, you have to consider many things, with the most important one being the type of game that you want to make. Because if you want to create the next GTA and decide to use struts, well, that's not gonna happen. Other things that you should keep in mind are the ease of use, the community support, the company behind the game engine and how trustworthy they are. I'm looking at you, Unity. So today I'm gonna cover all the main game engines and I will give my opinion about them and rank them from S tier to D tier. Let's get started with the most famous one by far, Unity. This is the first real game engine that I ever used, no offense to struts, and it has many advantages. The best thing about it, in my opinion, is how flexible it is. You want to make 2D games? You can. You want to make 3D games? You can. You want to export to console or mobile? Sure, why not? And all that is absolutely amazing, but it comes at a cost. The first time you open the engine, you will get bombarded with so much information and so many options that you may want to close it and take a while to reconsider. And this is a cost that you will have to assume if you want to access all the powerful tools that Unity offers. The problem is, you may not need them, and in that case, all that suffering will be unnecessary. For example, if you are 100% sure about wanting to stick to 2D games forever, starting with Unity, which includes many tools oriented towards 3D, may not be the best option for a beginner. The first time I installed it and tried to follow a tutorial, I literally finished the 3-hour tutorial without understanding a single thing about what I just did. So Unity's complexity and power are both an advantage and a disadvantage, but there is a really good aspect that compensates how complex it may seem at first, which is the community. Unity's community is huge. You can find specific tutorials about anything. And if by any chance there isn't a tutorial, you will most likely find some forum where the question that you were asking has already been answered. And this is something that you should definitely consider when picking an engine, because it doesn't matter how easy it is to use. From time to time, you're gonna need help, so this gives extra points to Unity. But I already talked way too well about them, so let's start the beef. First of all, we have the programming language. Unity uses C#. I'm gonna get tons of hate from other software engineers, but I hate it. I know that it's more efficient than Python or JavaScript, but the average person won't ever notice that, so I prefer a prettier and simpler programming language. If you already have experience with C# or other more complex languages, then this won't be a big deal, but it will be if you're a complete beginner. On top of that, the company behind Unity has already lost all the trust from game developers because of their previous actions. The main one that you probably already heard about was when they decided to change the pricing system. And not happy with that, they decided that they will apply the changes retroactively. On top of that, Unity is losing money every single year. It's not a profitable company, which means that at any point, it could stop existing. So now let's rank it. If you want to create super powerful games, try different options like 2D, 3D, export to every platform, etc., then I think it's a good option, probably an A tier. But if you want to make simple games for PC and mobile, and stick mostly to 2D or basic 3D, then it loses its main advantage. If on top of that, we consider that the company behind it is not trustworthy at all, I'm afraid I will have to lower it to B. I wouldn't say it's a C or D because it's really powerful, as I said, but you know, with great power comes great responsibility, and I am not trusting those bits. Now we have Scratch, which is a game engine mostly focused towards teaching programming basics for kids. I actually have a video where I remake my first game ever that I made using Scratch when I was 9, that you can check out if you want. Now, the thing with Scratch, as I said, is that it's designed to teach the basics. And it's quite good at that, but that's about it. If you want to create a serious game, it's a big no-no. On top of that, the community is mostly composed by kids 8 to 12. So that's also a negative aspect to consider. It's not powerful at all. It only supports 2D and it uses blocks to build the logic instead of a programming language, which is a great way to learn, but incredibly slow compared to just writing code. So as an overall game engine, I unfortunately cannot place it above D. But yeah, you should use it to teach your kids how to code, not to build a game. Next, RPG Maker. This engine gets lots of hate because there are many really bad games made with it. But I think that some of that hate is undeserved. First, let's talk about its flexibility and how powerful it is. It's not. It's neither powerful nor flexible. I mean, I think that part is quite obvious. It has the word RPG in the name. So obviously you're not gonna make shooters or whatever with it. But this is also an advantage, because if you're sure about wanting to make an RPG, it is a great option. For example, take a look at Fear and Hunger, an amazing game developed using RPG Maker, or To the Moon, one of my favorite games when I was young. I actually did try RPG Maker in the past, and it is really easy to use. So if you want a story-driven RPG without worrying too much about the programming aspects of game dev, then go for it. By the way, I have a video about what the best game genres are for beginner indie game developers. So you should probably check that out as well. Another advantage is that it's a one-time payment, so I think it deserves a C tier. Once again, only if you want to make RPGs, otherwise it's just not a real option. And it's time for my favorite one, which is Godot. I've been using it for around 8 or 9 months, and I absolutely love it. First of all, it's free. Always and forever free. It doesn't matter if you make $0 or a million. You will get to keep all of it. I mean, except for Steam's cut and taxes and all that stuff. But other than that, it's all yours. On top of that, it's quite flexible, giving you the option to create both 2D and 3D games, and to export the final product for web, mobile, and desktop. I know that there are some ways to export for consoles as well, but in this case, it's not as easy as it is with Unity, unfortunately. Another positive aspect is the community. While it is not nearly as big as that of Unity, you can still find many tutorials and forums out there, making it a great option for people with no previous experience. The language that it uses is JavaScript, which is similar to Python and really easy to use. It does support C# and C++, if you are migrating from Unity or Unreal, but it will be harder to find resources for that, so I will still recommend sticking to its native language. Now, Godot is not as powerful as Unity, that is true, but that is also a relatively good thing, because for small to medium-sized projects, it will be so much easier to get started and actually finish a game, instead of wasting hours trying to figure out which pipeline renderer to use. Last but not least, after Unity messed up by changing their policies and losing many game devs, Godot thrived from this, receiving lots of monetary support as well as just general support, meaning that it will grow faster than ever from now on. And because it's open source, you can modify the engine as much as you want. I don't recommend doing it, but you can. So with all that being said, I am placing Godot in S tier. And now we are going back to 2D games with Game Maker Studio. While it is not as powerful as Godot or Unity, it's an engine that has lots of official tutorials, which is obviously a great thing if you are getting started. On top of that, you can create games without needing to actually code, as you can use their visual scripting tool to create full games. It also changed its pricing not too long ago, meaning that you can get started completely for free. And in order to publish, it's just a one-time purchase, which is great. Not everything is good though. The community is even smaller than Godot's, and at some point it may be too restrictive, forcing you to migrate to a different engine. So I would consider it a great first step, but not a great overall game engine, making it a C tier. Next one we have Construct, which is similar to Game Maker Studio, I believe. I actually haven't used it myself. But let's talk about the community. If you go to the official website, you will see a store section, where people post plugins and stuff. Now, every big engine offers a similar store, but the problem with this one is that from what I can see, all plugins are paid, which feels a bit wrong. One thing I love about Godot is that you can find many free resources from people who just wanted to help others. While in Construct you can see many templates aimed towards creating copy-paste games like Match 3 or 2048, which is not the kind of community I want to be a part of. On top of that, the engine is restricted for the free plan, where you can only have 50 events, for example, or 500 lines of JavaScript, which is just a trash pricing system. Also, it seems like the Spanish translation is only available for the paid version. I am not sure, but if that's the case, that is also trash behavior. If you use Construct, please comment whether that is the case or if the info is just missing on the website. But anyways, I am afraid we have our first F tier, because you cannot just restrict things like events and lines of code behind a paywall. It feels like an engine created by EA or Ubisoft. And we continue with another JavaScript-based engine, which is Phaser. Now, Phaser is not actually a game engine, it's a framework, and it's focused on creating browser games rather than big commercial releases. A good thing about Phaser is that it's open source. So if you want to create small HTML games, you can absolutely go for it. Especially if, just like me, you're a web developer, it should be extremely easy to get started. But as a general game engine, it cannot compete with others. There is an engine for it to create games in a more visual way, but you will have to pay a monthly subscription in order to use it, which, once again, I am not a big fan of. So I think it's going into D tier as a game engine, with some specific use cases that may bring it up to C. Just remember what it is used for, and don't get mad when you cannot create the game of your dreams using it. And we are finally getting close to the end with GDevelop. Once again, this is an engine focused mostly on 2D games, although you can create 3D games as well. And it also allows you to create games without writing a single line of code, which seems to be really popular. I honestly think that you should learn programming if you want to be a game dev, because it will open so many possibilities. But if you want to avoid it at all costs, GDevelop can be a great option. The community around it is surprisingly big, considering that it's definitely not as famous as Unity or Godot, and they also release official tutorials that are extremely useful. You can pay a subscription of $5 a month for the basic plan or $35 per year if you want some help publishing the game. But it is not really mandatory, it's just an extra help to export your games, but you can still publish them for free with some extra work. I think that just because of the community, the official support, and the relatively inexpensive price, it deserves a B tier. Just know that it's not as powerful and popular as Unity, which is also a B, but I think that aspect is compensated by the fact that you can actually trust the company behind it. Before we talk about the last game engine, let's talk about another option that you may have considered, which is creating your own game engine. Now, this is a good option if you're a AAA studio, or if you want to learn how to create game engines, but not if you want to learn how to create games. So it's going into its own category, but I would never recommend it myself. And the last game engine I'm gonna talk about is obviously Unreal Engine. This is probably the most powerful engine on the list, and it is focused on creating 3D games. You can create 2D games, yes, but if that's your use case, it will probably be a waste of resources. Unreal Engine offers a blueprint system that allows you to create games without writing actual code, but you can always choose to write your code using C++, which is a language that I don't really like, but it is what it is. Unreal Engine is also extremely powerful when it comes to all the visual stuff, and you can create absolute masterpieces worthy of a museum for free. Another advantage is that there are so many tutorials out there, as well as a really big community built around it. So you will most likely have no problems finding help online, just like with Unity. The company behind it is Epic Games, which is a great thing, because that means that they don't really depend on Unreal Engine to be profitable. Meaning that, unlike Unity, they don't have to worry about losing money with it. They also offer many free things. For example, the first Tuesday of every month, they will make a few assets completely free to use. So if you think that you may use it someday, you should definitely start claiming them today. The pricing system is also amazing, as you only have to pay after you exceed $1 million in revenue. And honestly, if I am making that much, I don't really care about paying a percentage of it. And they can also provide funding for your game if you get selected for their program. Unreal can also be used for other things outside game dev, like movies, architecture, product design, and more. The only downside that I see is that, just like it happens with Unity, it's so powerful that it will take a while to get used to it. Also, it is not really oriented towards mobile games. That doesn't mean that you cannot create them, but it may be tricky, as many of the systems inside the engine require good hardware. So don't expect to make one of those huge, gorgeous games using Unreal and publishing it for mobile. But I think that is quite obvious. So with all this being said, Unreal is a clear S tier, probably above Godot, but I won't place it there because I hate Epic Games for creating Fortnite and the Epic Store. Like, seriously, has anyone ever used Epic Store other than to claim the free games? It's just horrible. Now that you have picked a game engine for your game, hopefully Godot or Unreal, you have to decide the game genre and the idea. So you should probably check these videos next. See ya!